le français. Bonjour chers amis, j'espère que vous allez bien. Hello my friends, I hope that you are all doing well. So today I want to tell you about habitat in France, where French people live, how they live. This video is available in French language, so if you want you can also check the French one. So first of all, what type of construction do we have in France? France, I always tell you, France is the most beautiful country on earth. Okay, I don't know if it's true, but I mean it. I don't know if it's true because you have to see the things by yourself. You don't know. If you don't travel, if you don't go to the place, you have no clue, you have no idea how it looks like. But one thing for sure, the weather here is very good. It's not humid. Most of the world, in Asia, I think in the US, it's humid. It can be a little bit cold in winter, but never too cold. It can be a little bit hot in summer, but never too hot, okay? So that's a very, very good country. That's for the weather. And then if you look at the patrimoine, at what we have left, this is very beautiful because for the housing, you had different housing in France, four different places, south, north, east, west. You have different kind of architecture. Why? Because the local people, they will always use local material to build the house. So let me illustrate. And anyway, stay tuned on this channel because I'm going to travel. And I will show you everything. So you are going to see all this. So give me thumbs up, support me on Patreon. I'm going to show you all this. I'm going to teach you French language at the same time. I'm going to show you all this. So for instance, next to Germany or in the north, where you used to have the coal mine, you have a little bit the same architecture as in the UK. So you have these red housing, red bricks. I think it's not very nice. They are all these red bricks. In the center of France, where I'm right now, you have the white stone. There's the white stone that was digged up from the cave. And this is a white stone that all the castles are built with this white stone. And all the cities, the old cities, the church, they are built with this white stone. It's very beautiful. If you go to Brittany is a place of France that's next to the sea, nearby Great Britain, Brittany, many housing are built of granite, which is a kind of gray rock, and this rock comes from les falaises. It's the rock that you have that face the sea. So they dig inside this, they make this big stone, and they build some small housing this way. If you go to next to the coast, to some village that is fisherman village or fisherman city, you will see all the homes are painted in the same color because there was just one color available, and that's how people would do it. If you go to in Paris, you have all the buildings that many of the housing that will be like Haussmann, the Haussmannian style. So there are many different types. If you go to Normandy is in the north of France, Normandy, you will see many of the houses are made of wood. They have the wooden inside is wood, the wooden roof, and the roof is made of chaume. Chaume is kind of straw. The straw. So every 5 years you have to, if you buy a home like this, every 5 years you have to change the roof. And because there was no tile, you know. If you go to Toulouse, you will see all the pink roof from the home, because this is the pink stone that is from the area that people use to cover the home. So you can see different home in different architecture, because you have different people who have different knowledge, different know-how, and also you have a little bit the weather is different, so people will build the home in a different style and they will use the local material. If you go to Burgundy, you have the Bourgogne stone, the Pierre de Bourgogne, which is a white stone and very, very solid. So you have many villages, the walls are very thick and make of this Burgundy stone. Then there is another thing, is from the architecture, you can see the time, the history, and that's something very rich all over France. You will see the history, you can see some village, you know, or castle, you know, this is built from the Middle Age with the small housing. And then you can see something that is built in Renaissance, like this home was built in Renaissance under Napoleon, was built under Napoleon time. You can see some home that were built during the Industrial Revolution, we say Maison Bourgeoise. Depending on the home, you can also see the social class. Some castles, they used to belong to the king or to the people next to the king. Everybody was after the king. They also had their own small castles. That's why you have so many castles in France. You had some castles that belonged to the knight, some belonged to some duke, some belonged to some comte, you know. And these are private castles now, most of them. So you cannot visit them, but you can see it from the outside. And then you have also many houses that are just for bourgeois, you know, the traders or some people who were doing some business, who were wealthy, but they were not noblemen. Then you have some house that belongs to the factory owner. You have different buildings. It's very interesting because there's a real history. Real history behind all this. It's very sad, however, that we destroy everything. Everything is going down. If you come today to France and you have been around to ugliness, I have been in China for the past 12 years, it's very disappointing to go in China. If you will go there, you will be disappointed, except you go to Tibet or Yunnan, you will be disappointed. There is nothing left. They just destroyed everything. And if you go to France, it's a little bit the same. Whenever there is money to be made, they will destroy. You see down the garden, I think I didn't show you, there used to be an old manufacturer. I will go there to show you. And they destroyed it all, they just kept the wall. Manufacturer is an old factory, huh, that dates back from the king, I think Louis the 14th or Louis the 15th, and they built this factory. I think they were doing some clothes, but they destroyed it. It was very interesting. They didn't keep it. They destroy everything because they can make money. They can build a new, and that's the thing. So there's been a construction immobilière. La construction immobilière, it's the new construction. Maybe I will tell you this in another video. I will tell you about construction immobilière in another video. But things are being destroyed because there's always money, gross model. Okay, let's destroy and build a new building. Let's destroy and build a new road. Let's destroy and do... Or the upkeep cost is too much, we'll wait. And sometimes they don't want to destroy because they know people are going to complain. And many homes, they are 100 years old, it's not protected. Nothing is protected. Only the big monuments, like if it's older than 400 years old, okay, maybe it will be protected, maybe. But the rest is not protected, so you have many, many houses. This house, that where I am right now, 250 years old, I can destroy it if I want, huh? I don't care. You know, it's not protected. If I want to destroy the whole house and build a small modern house inside, I could do this. You know, it's not protected. Yeah. Okay, bon. Let me leave you. À bientôt, les amis. Au revoir.